Hello everyone, this is Direwolf20 and welcome to episode 37 of Direwolf20 Server Play Series. I'm hanging out playing with some magic spell creation processes. As you can see, I've been making a few spells here. I have them in my inventory. A couple new ones that I want to show you that I'm pretty happy with. I'm really impressed with, by the way, the Rift spell. Hanging out with Soren and CPW on TeamSpeak. A-Dubs is here but not talking. Eddie Ruckus looks like he's on the server but not in TeamSpeak with us. How you guys doing?
Hello.
What's up? Have you seen the Rift? Rift is so cool. Have you seen Rift CPW?
No.
It's really cool. I'm coming to visit CPW.
Run.
Hello.
Oh, hey, dude. I was just about to kill some enemies. Oh, I forgot.
Oh, nice. User joined your channel. Good timing.
I'm trying to build a shard.
Cool.
Fun. There's not in that. Okay, Tog! Here we go. Wrong TeamSpeak channel.
Hey, Tog, hey. What's up?
Seems like Echo.
Yeah.
How are you doing?
Not too bad.
I haven't seen you in a while.
Yeah.
Kinda I'm recording, bored. Just so you know.
Yeah.
Just so you know. CBW, where'd you go?
I went to get my shard.
Oh, are you in Digger or Overworld? I want to show you this
awesome
spell.
Oh, I just went back to Overworld. I'm coming back to the end now.
Okay, cool. I want to show you this cool spell that I got. It's called Rift.
To kill you with it.
I also got Banish Rain, which I haven't tested yet, but I definitely want to try.
Okay.
Check this out.
Whoa, what the heck?
Right click it.
Oh, is that the chest?
It's got little red X's on it.
Yep. Oh, okay. That's because I cast it with like a low casting mode. If I cast it like full mode, though I don't know if I can have two at a time open, so I might have to wait for this one to go away. But then I'll have like the whole thing opened. How cool is that?
So it's just kind of random, like a summonable chest or what?
Yeah, like I can summon it whenever I want, put items in it, and then I presume I'll have access to them later. I'm going to put my admin anchor in there. Because it's cheaty anyway.
I have a potato.
I don't know if there's a way
actually,
to banish
I put a potato in there. Can you see the potato?
I cannot. I only see the admin anchor.
So it must be per user store.
Yeah. So we all summon a Rift. It doesn't matter who summoned it. It matters who accesses it. That's kind of cool.
Yeah. Personal storage.
So you can't steal from my Rift. Haha.
No, I cannot, apparently.
So now if I access, like, if I cast this in full-blown casting mode, I'm guessing it's not going to cast at all. That's what's going to happen. There it goes. Okay. Yep. Now it has access to the whole thing. It's kind of nice how it opens up, though, huh? Isn't it like really nice particle effects when it opens up?
That's weird. I can only put stuff in the very first slot.
Oh?
First row.
You're right. I can only put things in the first row either. Yep. First row is the only one available. Interesting. That's weird. Oh well. Something to play with. You know, work in progress mod and all that. Now that's weird. Indeed. When I have it in half casting mode, I can access all slots.
Yeah, you can access all three rows.
Yeah, but in full mode, I can only access the one row. So I guess he's maybe the opposite of what he meant to do or something. You know how things are backwards and weird sometimes. Still awesome looking, though. I like it.
Well, here you come. That's it.
Yes, kill all the Endermen and make us a nice, awesome place.
Please. Here, too, with 160 kills. I'm trying to get enough experience to actually try and enchant for a Soul Stealer.
Oh, nice. I wonder if you can access the Soul Stealer with the thing in our base. Probably not, I would think. Because is the Soul Stealer even available anymore? Do you have to put it on a certain weapon, do you know? I know he was in the process of changing his Soul Stealer enchant. I don't know what he did.
I think it was available, because I think this was just a straight port from 1.5, and it was definitely available in 1.5.
I thought it was in the game, but like disabled, so that you couldn't access it.
I think it goes on any sword. You don't need to have it on a specific sword.
Is that the case? Interesting.
Maybe.
Let me put my lightning spell in here, because I did also make a lightning spell. Let's get a sword. And I'll see if you can enchant it on a stone sword, for example. Let's see if we can put it in our cultic enchanter thingy. So we get smite, sharpness, knockback, bane of arthropods, looting, and fire aspect. But I don't see anything that's... Yeah, I didn't see anything that was soul stealer-ish. In 1.4, it was like a unique sword, but let's check out...
Yeah, 1.5, he changed it to go on any weapon that was enchantable.
Yeah. There is a Shadow Blade, but it doesn't have a texture. In 1.6,
because I don't think he'd updated that mechanic yet.
Gotcha. There is a Shadow Blade listed in NEI, but it doesn't have a texture, so... Interesting. Alright, guys, I want to get started with more UU Matter production. I haven't set up everything that I need to yet, so we're going to see that happen today. I did let my scrap run overnight, so we can see our scrap machine's no longer running. And if we take a look, we should see we have over 10,000 scrap. 10,263 to be exact. Awesome. Alright, be right back. Okay, we're back, guys. Let's set up some cool stuff with the mass fab. Hopefully, this all works. I just have to run this stuff. Let's see. I've got some stuff there. I would love to be able to bring it up here. I've already got, like, spacing issues here, don't I? It's mine.
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm having issues with space. So let's see. Where can I run this thing up so that it's not completely obnoxious? Oh, you know what else I need to do? I'm like, why aren't I flying? I know what I need to do. Where's my...
Dance.
I could dance, but I probably don't need to dance.
Lame.
Where's my wand?
Over there.
It's weird. My wand's, like, suddenly missing. Oh, well. That's interesting. Maybe I put in my AE system by mistake. Nope. Alright. Oh, right. I put it in the table when I was looking at things. Aw, Enderman killing you. There we go. Now we got flight. Alright, so let's do this, right? Let's say we want to hook up this AE system so that we can export scrap. Now we're talking. Yeah. Such a mess of cabling down here. This is why I didn't want this. I wanted to have this, like, underground basement of stuff. Also, this one's all... Okay, yeah, that should be fine. There's just so many cables and wires and pipes that need to be running all over the place. But ideally, it'll be nice and hidden from, you know, public view. So let's say we did it like this. Just run it straight down here like that. That should connect. Cool. And I'm thinking facades. Definitely. There, and this guy here, and here. Nice! And then we can precision export our scrap, like so. I'll just put one in here. Now this thing, by the way, is set up to no amplifier, redstone signal. This thing is set up when it's receiving a redstone signal, it's not running. So as soon as I put scrap in here, we have amplifier. And we're inserting scrap faster than we're using it. So I can just leave it at single item at a time mode, that's fine. And it'll just burn up all that amplifier. I don't suppose there's a bonus to combining your scrap into scrap boxes. It's probably just 9 times as much. So there's no real point in crafting it. I don't need to tie up my crafting system. I don't like having, like, auto-crafting recipes if I don't have to. Like, this'll work just fine. It just, you know, it saves us a step. So, we're producing UU Matter. Soren, you should be very pleased.
Yay!
Hooray! What? That's cool.
And then, get your purple, you know, buckets.
What's that?
Purple buckets, because purple.
Right. Now if I take this out, redstone signal goes on, and... Why are you randomly putting things in there? Oh, right! That's funny. Okay. Always active. There we go. You get the point. that redstone signal was traversing through the mass fab and activating this. Cool. So we're good. All right. So scrap's running, mass fab's running. UU matter should, liquid form, pump through the pipes and land in this tank over here. And we'll see if that works out. I have an idea or two. Hey, Soren.
Hey, Dyer.
I'm pretty sure that Mikey's scanners can read the contents of a tank.
Right.
I'm just mentioning that for your sunglasses overlay thing.
Ah, yeah.
Yeah, that might be cool. That's something we have to look into in the future. By the way, I did add a, I said I wasn't going to do this, but I did it. I added a steam turbine here because basically we started producing or using much more energy, especially with the coming UU matter production. I knew I was going to be using more energy. So long story short, I needed to use more energy than my uranium was producing and especially more than my radioisotope generators were using. So I decided, let's add the steam turbine now. You can see I've got wireless redstone hooked up so that anytime the MFSU drops low, it enables this cable over here. So this will prevent the steam turbine from running if we're not draining a lot of power, because basically if these things can keep my generator and my base going, it'll break the cable here. You can kind of see it breaking, and it's going to turn off the steam turbine whenever that happens. But if we drop low, for example, because we ran out of uranium or whatever, then no big deal, right? So I should maybe consider automating it so that it stops the UU matter production when we get really low. But yeah, we'll see. I don't know. We'll see what we can do there. Maybe I'll put a second MFSU and read off that. Something along those lines. We'll see how it goes for now, and then we'll come back to check on it. So UU matter production is in progress. Let's set up the replicator and the UU matter thingy that we need to do. And the scanner. I think that's it. Yes, scanner and replicator. So let's see what's involved in those crafting recipes. Scanner. 512 EU per tick max. That's a lot of EU per tick. And whoa, that's a lot of stuff that they make me put in there. Advanced machine casing, electronic motors. Whoever thought that producing matter from energy would be so complex? We will be back after some painful crafting recipes. I'm pretty sure I have most of this stuff covered, though. All right, guys, I'm partway through making what I need. I already have a scanner, and I'm working on a replicator. And for this, I need some reinforced stone. So I want to show you guys the process to make it, as it was just explained to me. I think iron item casings, that's what gets me iron fence things.
Iron scaffold.
Yeah. Well, I need iron scaffold to get the iron fences, or the other way around. So I just made 16 iron scaffold, and then I have to inject it with the CF foam?
That's right.
Okay, iron item casing and universal CF powder. Holy cow, what is going on here? Oh good, stone dust. I have tons of that. Clay, I do not have tons of that. So let's see, CF foam sprayer, universal fluid cell is tin item casings around a glass pane. And then I'm going to need some iron, what was it, CF plates? Yeah, iron item casings. Must never have taught my iron item casings recipe. That's okay, we'll just do a manual real quick. We'll teach it later. Do you have to use a CF sprayer for foam?
Yeah, pretty much. You can't do it otherwise now, because CF spray is now a liquid.
Ah, so you didn't have to in the past, I don't think. You didn't have to use the sprayer.
No, what you do is you make the CF pellets, and then you put them in the panner with water, and it will turn into a CF spray.
You put it into what with water? The canner?
Canner.
Oh my goodness.
Canning machine.
They are not making this easy. Where's my canning machine? So I put that in with water?
What you do is you put the, in the top left, first of all you need it in fluid enrich mode.
Okay.
Okay, in the top left you put the CF sprayer.
Okay.
In the middle you put the CF foam, 8 stacks, 8 is a full CF spray.
Can I just do it with one?
Yeah, maybe. One will do. And then put a bucket of water into the tank. No, don't do it like that, because you're going to the wrong tank.
How do I get a bucket of water in?
You have to pipe it in. You can do that if you go and make one of their universal fluid cells.
Yeah.
And put water in it, you can right-click on the canner and it will go in the right tank.
I'm just waiting for, like, an explosion to go off.
I know, right? Alright, so I can universal fluid cell it. There we go. It's doing something!
Yeah, so it should go in the left, yeah, and there you go. And it should, if you look at the CF, it's now got 1,000 millibuckets in it.
Oh, that's cool. I'm going to put it back in canning mode.
Use the mode key, and you can squirt single blocks with it in your hand, same as a wrench.
I see, yeah. Mode single. Cool. And then one, two, just like this, replacing it.
Yeah, that's regular CF foam, and if you put it on an iron scaffold, you'll get into armored stone.
Yeah, no, I put it in the... I just do that, right?
Yep, that's right. And then just use sand on it, and it'll dry straight out.
Cool. That's not terrible. I'm lying, it's terrible.
Mean.
All right. Well, we've got some. You know what? In fairness, though, I guess that's a little better than it used to be, especially because you could probably do a pretty good nuclear reactor building using this stuff.
Yeah, I've got a little bunker out of it.
Yeah, I need to tell player that I don't like making 4 thick walls. 4 blocks thick is just way too much.
He said that it's not necessary to make it that thick anymore. I think 2 is enough.
Yeah, I tested it recently and it was not. I think he was trolling you, trying to get you to blow up your house.
Well, I've only got 1 thick at my house.
Alright, what's that thing called? Pattern storage? Oh boy, more reinforced stone, more advanced machine casings. Alright guys, we will be back. For these, one of these, and I will see you in a moment. Alright guys, we're back. So here we go. Replicator. Pattern storage and scanner. This is kind of the way you're going to want to set it up when you build your own UU Matter system. So your scanner can scan blocks. Your pattern storage stores the pattern of all the blocks that you scanned, and they have to be adjacent to each other. At this point, there's no way to scan it and, like, get it to the pattern storage unless the pattern storage is next to it. And the same deal with the replicator. The replicator can read all the patterns in the adjacent pattern storage and use UU matter to and energy, of course, to create the stuff. So let's see what we can do. So the first thing I'm going to scan, and of course I'm going to need power. I think the two on the ends require power. Pattern storage, unsure if it needs power or not. Let's see. Pattern storage, it doesn't have a tooltip indicating power use. Scanners can use up to 112, I want to say, or 512. Yeah, 512. And then the replicator, I think, can use up to, like, ultra current, which is 2048 EU per tick max. So replicators, obviously, can take a lot of EU. So let's run some power. Here we go. Right along here, I'm thinking. 1, 2, 3. Do I have fiber cabling on me? Why would I? That's a silly thing to have. I don't need this, do I, Soren?
No.
No, not at all.
It's wireless, right?
Sure, why not? Maybe I used up the last of my fiber cable.
That's it.
I must have, because I don't have any at all.
Oh. Maybe A-dubs took it. Hmm.
Is A-Dubs going to speak, or is he like, nah, I'm good?
He said, let's see, A-Dubs is about to speak, is what he wanted to tell you.
Oh boy, should I pause for dramatic effect?
I have no idea. That works.
Fair enough. A-Dubs is trolling us with his lack of speaking, because now he has a microphone, but he's not going to talk. I see how it is.
You know, apparently he's always had one since it's built in.
Oh, okay.
He just doesn't like talking to us. He hates us.
I see how it is. It's all right, buddy. I understand. All right, so pattern, scanner, we're ready. We've got power flow, right? Yeah, we look good here. How is my magnet going? The mysterious magnet is good to go. Let's do it, shall we? All right, so the first thing, I think I'll teach it how to make stone bricks. I wonder if this will work. I don't know. He said anything that you can mine right now is implemented, so stone bricks might not actually work. Maybe I should do something simple like cobblestone. So obviously the scanner takes a while. Error, energy loss. Error, energy loss. Oh boy, that's not
error.
Good. We can't be out of energy. Maybe I'm just running too much on one line. Yeah, I must be. I mean, this is the same line that I'm pumping energy into the this thingy with. I mean, I could make a manual override. Let's do that. I should probably just have this thing running when I'm not online. How are we for you, you matter? Ooh, look, we're starting to get some. Soren, we have 2 buckets worth so far. 2! It's easier for you to throw you matter around because now it's a liquid. All right, now
I've
we should have
enough. I've got 89.
Nice. All right, energy's doing a little better now, but I think it needs like a steady 512 to run smoothly because, I mean, I'm dumping out a lot of juice here, and it's not enough. Apparently. Alright. Give me a minute or two, guys. I also want to make sure that this thing is set properly. Yeah, fixed step down. That's good. I can't read EU usage right now, which is killing me a little bit. But apparently this guy needs a lot of juice to run steady. I bet I could do something like maybe... Do I have a Lapitron crystal with 10 million EU in it? I wonder if that'll work. Nope. Probably needs a regular energy crystal. All right, let's see. Let's see if that'll work. Man, I gotta ask them about that. So once this is full, we'll be back, guys. All right, let's see if this works. Well, that's definitely better. Wow, that is draining energy like there's no tomorrow. What the heck? Did it completely cut that energy crystal's power in half, or is it me? Like, I put a completely full energy crystal in there, and it, like, zapped it in half, I thought. Unless I'm crazy about something. I might be crazy. Alright, let's see what happens. I want to grab another full energy crystal.
Hey,
you know what it is.
Hey.
Alex, what's up?
Oh, not much. I came here to poke CPW.
Ah. I'm recording just as a heads up. Yep. Yeah, it looks like this scanner has a nice bit of energy buffer storage, but if it's not getting 512, it's not enough to scan. Very interesting. I might need a dedicated power line for pretty much everything here. You know, I could have a separate MFSU, 2 of them being powered, 1 MFSU powering most of my base, and a second MFSU powering the other stuff. That probably wouldn't be a bad idea, honestly, just because I don't want my base's power to suffer as a result of UU matter production. Soren doesn't mind that happening, typically.
Hey.
But
hey.
Typically, Soren's okay with that kind of thing. And I could even, like, paint the lines if I really wanted to.
What do you mean, typically? I thought it was normal for Soren.
Exactly.
All the UU.
Yeah.
All of it.
Soren's like, ah, what do we need UU matter for? We're good.
What? What are you talking about?
Yeah.
Another Soren I don't know about.
Exactly. You'll always sacrifice our base's power. You're like, oh, we don't need to run this base. I want more UU to throw a dire while he's recording. Pretty much, yeah. All right.
Yeah.
Give me a minute. I want to think through how I want to rerun this power line stuff, because obviously I want to be able to power my main base separate from the UU matter stuff. So give me a few. I'll be right back. Okay, we're back again. And what do we got here? Cool, my scanner finished. Definitely uses a lot of energy to scan. Lots of energy. Let's store that. There we go. And over here, we should see pattern storage of cobblestone. Cool. UU matter in millibuckets is 4. UU matter is spelled wrong, so I'll have to tell Thunderdark and tease him about that. And power in EU. Yeah, matter with 1T.
Got it.
And we need 128 power in EU. You know what I want to scan because I do not have a lot of? Resin. I would absolutely love to be able to UU matter resin. Like, for real, because, like, obviously setting up a rubber tree farm wouldn't be terribly hard, but I would actually like to do that. So, actually, let's... Come on. I think my game's just lagging a little bit. There it goes. It did register, it just... My game didn't see it. Cool. Let's hit up Dire's old place. I should have... Yeah, I'm lagging a little bit tonight, I'm telling you.
Overworld?
What's that?
Overworld?
Not particularly overworld, just anytime I jump from one dimension to the next. I'm just gonna get a single piece of resin. Should probably just get a bunch of resin while I'm out here, but I'll get that later. Pahimar joined the game. Oh boy, that's dangerous.
Indeed.
Joined the game. Oh, he joined Forgecraft or something?
Yeah.
He lost the game.
Yeah.
All right. Gonna scan some of this stuff. We'll let that
All right.
Work.
Catch you guys later.
See you, CPW.
Ah, okay. I was getting Palmar on here to talk about it, but if you're interested in CPW, I'm just going to propose it to Palmar and then see what happens.
All right, guys. We'll be back once Sticky Resin's done scanning too. Uh-oh, guys. We got an error on the scanner. I guess sticky resin doesn't work yet.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Oh, yeah, it's only ores right now.
I know. I was hoping... He said world gen ores, so I was like, maybe sticky resin. Apparently not. All right, where's my wrench? I'm going to start storing power in this MFSU in front of me here that I just placed down. As soon as I find my wrench.
Over there.
I've got too many tool chest things. Yeah, I have no idea where my wrench went. That's cool. How can I not have... Where is it?
You see, you make fun of the sword chest until you lose things. I know most things I put in my sword chest. It's just a lot of stuff.
I'll just make another one. There we go. So I'm just going to get power running to this thing. There we go. So that'll start draining power from this thing, which will obviously kick up its turbine production. Yeah, there we go. Cool. Power is being produced. Awesome. So the turbine will kick up. The nuclear reactor will start running. I'm thinking I might... I think I'll just cut this guy off for a minute. Let's do this. That will disable it. And that'll allow this thing to run at full blast. So it'll never turn off now until I switch this back to the right frequency. And that'll allow this thing to fill up nice and quick, especially with the help of the nuclear reactor. So that'll be good too. I might even, just to help speed this along, grab a little bit of redstone. Here's my little trick for diverting this. That allows the reactor to run because it pulls the redstone signal away from the torch. Haha. Who doesn't know vanilla now, Soren?
You.
You're probably correct. Who's this, Bahamar in front of me?
Probably. I'm not, so...
Oh, noes! Morphage. Bahamar! Bahamar was slain by an entity biomes a plenty jungle spider dot name.
Oh, oh damn. A-dubs.
How terrible.
It sounds scary.
Until you read it.
Yeah.
And then it just looks scarier.
I'm going to grab a bucket of UU matter. You know what? I might need that universal fluid cell. We'll see if this works for storing UU matter. Can I just steal a bucket worth? Like, can I put this in here? Nope. How about in here? Nope. Let's see what else I got going on. How can I store some of this UU matter? I guess I can't just put it in this thing, huh? I will find a way. I'm thinking Ender Tank it over there. We'll see. All right, guys, we'll be back in a second. There we go. I checked and I saw that there was a UU matter cell, so I assumed that putting an empty universal fluid cell in the mass fab would work, and it appears to have. Perfect. Let's get back over here. And can I put the cell in here then, I presume? Nice. Cool. So it just needs to be told what to make. So for now, the only thing it knows how to make is cobble. So if I want to make a single cobble, it will. If I want it to make infinite cobble, it will. Obviously, I don't need to waste UU matter and energy on cobble because I've got tons of the stuff. Unfortunately, though, we do have to wrap up the episode. So for now, this is Direwolf 20 signing off. Hope you enjoyed the episode. We'll be back next time. Probably between this episode and next, I'll probably just run the cabling from this MFSU to the scanner and replicator, maybe. And probably power the UU matter production with this guy as well. I just have to figure out exactly how I want to determine when to use the UU matter production and when not. Because I don't want to, like, sacrifice the base's energy for it. But between these things here and my steam turbine running, we should be okay. We shouldn't have too much of a problem, but we'll see. Kind of play it by ear. I'm also hoping to let my uranium cells run out so I can make myself more plutonium. The RTG recipe has changed. It now requires 3 plutonium instead of 1, so it's 3 times as expensive. Yeah.
What does?
The RTG fuel.
Ah.
Yeah. Check out the recipe, Rorax. It's painfully more difficult now.
Hilarious.
Yeah. Plutonium was hard enough to come by as it was. Now it's even harder. So I might build my second nuclear reactor, too, off camera. I don't know. We'll see. We obviously need more power, so why not, right? So I would like to automate as best I can. Maybe I'll have, like, one nuclear reactor powering this thing and one powering this thing, or if I'll have both powering both. I don't know. I haven't figured it out. I will, and we'll get back to it. All right, guys. Direwolf20 signing off. Take it easy.